So today we are very fortunate that we are having His Grace Ramagirdhari Prabhu to enlighten us on Chaitanya Charitamrita. And we are very blessed to have Prabhuji's association on every week. So Prabhuji, are you present on the call? Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Prabhuji, are you here on the call?
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Yeah, Prabhuji is not.
I think Mataji, Prabhuji is not connected again.
Okay, let me check. Sorry. And I just logged in.
Okay, Mataji.
Introduction is over, Mataji?
Yes, Mataji. Actually, I thought like it's 11, so I started the recording also, so I can stop and then again you can start.
Okay, so no problem. The recording has started, that is well and good. It's a good thing.
Yeah, recording has been starting.
Okay, let me check, Mataji. Maybe he's getting delayed today. Let's see. Yeah, I don't see him on the list yet. There are like 6-7 callers, but I don't see his name on the list. So let's wait for a few minutes, Mataji.
Okay, Mataji, no problem.
Thank you, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna.
Yes, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Please accept my humble obeisances. All greetings to Srila Prabhupada, all greetings to Guru Maharaj. Thank you so much, Prabhuji, for your valuable association and for your valuable time. Now you can take over the call. Thank you so much, Prabhuji. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. Jaya Jaya Shri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda. Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. Jaya Jaya Shri Chaitanya Jaya Nityananda. Jaya Dvaita Chandra Jaya Gaura Bhakta Vrinda. So today we are reading from Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Leela, chapter 19, text number 55 onwards. So text number 55.
तबे महाप्रभु तांद्रे निकटे विशाइला सनातनेर वार्ताकः धनहरे भूचिला.
After this, Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu sat them down by his side and asked them, what news do you have of Sanatana?
Rupakahena tenho bandi haya rajagare. तुमी आदि उधार तबे हाइबे उधारे.
रूप गोस्वामी replied, Sanatana has now been arrested by the government of Husain Shah. If you kindly save him, he can be liberated from that entanglement. Text number 57.
प्रभु कहे सनातेन सनातनेर हंजा मोचना अचिरा तामसहा Haibe Milana.
Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu immediately replied, Sanatana has already been released from his confinement and he will very soon meet with me. Text number 58.
Madhyana Karite Vipra Prabhure Kahila Rupa Goshani Se Divasa Tatani Rahila.
The Brahmana then requested Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu to accept lunch. Rupa Goswami also remained there that day. Text number 59.
Bhattacharya Dui Bhaya Nimantrana Kaila Prabhu Rasesha Prasada Patra Dui Bhai Paila.
Balabhadra Bhattacharya invited two brothers to take lunch also. The remnants of food from the plate of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu were offered to them. Text number 60.
Triveni Upara Prabhura Vasa Gharastana Dui Bhai Vasa Khaila Prabhu Sannidhana.
Shri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu selected his residence beside the confluence of the Ganges and the Yamuna, a place called Triveni. The two brothers, Rupa Goswami and Sri Vallabha, selected their residence near the Lord's. So we will discuss from text number 55 through 60.
ॐ ज्ञानतिमिरान्धस्य ज्ञानाञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मिलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः. नमोऽं विष्णुपादाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्तिवेदान्त स्वामिन् इति नामिने. नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेषा शून्यवादी पाश्चात्याधेशतारिणे. जय श्री कृष्णा चैतन्यां प्रभु नित्यानंदां श्री अद्वैता गदाधर श्रीवासदी गौरभक्तवृंदा. हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 राम हरे राम Rama Rama Hare Hare.
So today we are discussing from Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita Madhya Leela, text number chapter 19, text number 55 through text number 16. So this is a topic where Lord Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is instructing Rupa Goswami. So to give you a quick prelude, so Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu is currently in Prayag, and Rupa Goswami had already left from Nawab Hussain Shah's custody, and along with his younger brother Anupam Malik, who is also called Sri Vallabha, Mahaprabhu has reached Sri Rupa Goswami, Rupa Goswami and Sri Vallabha has reached Mahaprabhu's place, and they have already met Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and they offered obeisances and glorified the Lord for his kindness. And these five verses are after they met Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So as soon as Rupa Goswami met Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu inquired from Rupa Goswami about Sanatana Goswami. And when Rupa Goswami expressed that Sanatana Goswami is still in the prison, arrested by Nawab Hussain Shah, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu made a prediction, or he has already made a statement, that Sanatana Goswami is already released from the prison, and very soon he is going to come and meet me. And then Balabhadra Bhattacharya took Mahaprabhu for lunch, and Mahaprabhu settled near Ganges, and then all they have had a good opportunity to accept the remnants of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. The very next verse, verse number 61, talks about one very great devotee. His name is Vallabhacharya. So Mahaprabhu is staying very close to a Brahmana called Vallabha Bhatta. So Anupam Malik is called Sri Vallabha, and Vallabha Bhatta is a South Indian Brahmin. So his glories are described in verse number 61 onwards. So we will let the next speaker to glorify Vallabhacharya in detail, because Prabhupada very nicely writes a purport on how Vallabhacharya is such a great devotee, and Prabhupada writes about his family and you know, various things. So to give a clarity, Vallabha Bhatta is Vallabhacharya, and eventually he is getting instruction from Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and he's part of one of the bona fide sampradayas, one of the four bona fide sampradayas. In today's discussion, we will churn more these five verses to understand the greatness of this Krishna consciousness process. Mahaprabhu, in his manifested incarnation, has shown extreme kindness. This whole incarnation is all about Mahaprabhu's love, which is Krishna's love for Srimati Radharani, and that emulated state, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, is so highly captivated in that state that he is profusely distributing his mercy to everybody. So Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's mood had always been trying to encompass, trying to accommodate people and win them this process of Krishna consciousness. When Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu met Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami at Ram Keli, he had already sown the seed and he had already expressed, and the bonding between Mahaprabhu and Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami were very nicely established, that Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami wouldn't want to continue anymore in Nawab Hussain Shah's kingdom or government. So by the care Mahaprabhu shows towards his associates, by the concern Mahaprabhu shows towards his disciples and followers, the kind of love that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gives to his disciples is so exemplary that we can see all the acharyas they are showing in their own behavior. In the first canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, Srila Prabhupada writes, the sages of Naimisharanya, they desired to assemble in Naimisharanya for the welfare of humanity. They all had been engaged in some activity or other in their personal life. One fine day they all decided that we need to serve the humanity at large, and hence let's give up our materialistic activities or other kind of sadhana that they have been doing on their own. And they gathered in Naimisharanya to inquire from Suta Goswami on how to deliver the people of humanity. Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami also had the same desire after they met Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Anyone who comes in contact with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they immediately get transformed. An interesting transformation happens is they change and they wish to change others. Unlike all the avatars, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu profusely gives his mercy, so much so that the practitioners would like to dedicate themselves for serving Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu by changing their own lifestyle as well as inspire others to practice this process. Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami, they had from the day one of their meeting with Mahaprabhu this urge of fully serving Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's movement. They were so focusedly desiring for that, Mahaprabhu reciprocated their urgency and trying to facilitate this meeting by his mercy. Even though last week we heard Rupa Goswami got a message from his servants that Sanatana Goswami is still in the prison and is trying to escape there, now we see Mahaprabhu is already predicting, is already declaring that Sanatana Goswami is going to be relieved and very soon he's going to come and meet him. A spiritual master always wish to give himself, to give his personal time, to give his instruction to those disciples who wish to follow in the footsteps of spiritual master and empathize the vision of spiritual master. So Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj, Srila Prabhupada, they are all very good examples where they did not have any desire apart from fulfilling Mahaprabhu's mission. We are going to have a few reflections in today's discussion which will help us to go deeper. Even though these five verses are just talking about some chronological event that happened, if we go in the background, we will understand that Mahaprabhu's intention, Mahaprabhu was longing to meet Rupa and Sanatana, and Rupa and Sanatana were longing to meet Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and this Milan is a very, very glorious, historical, and because of this Milan, we are currently sitting and hearing and discussing Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita. Had this Milan not happened, we would have not got any opportunity to know who Krishna is, what Vrindavan is, and what sort of person are we, and we would have really lost our track. So we are highly indebted to Sri Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, and the entire parampara for enabling us to be part of this process. So the first reflection that we need to bring here is, each and every one of us in this movement practicing Krishna consciousness should very deeply introspect to an extent to see, are we becoming a relevant disciple to our spiritual master? I am using this word called relevant disciple. I will clarify what that is as a part of our discussion. We all think that by just getting initiation, by just having a formal connection with our spiritual master, our spiritual life is set. Srila Prabhupada writes in Nectar of Devotion introduction. Srila Prabhupada writes, this Krishna consciousness movement is so sublime that each and every practitioner should try hard in getting involved in the activities of devotional service. I will read a paragraph from Nectar of Devotion introduction. Srila Prabhupada writes, this devotional service is a sort of cultivation. It is not simply inaction for people who like to be inactive or devote their time to silent meditation. There are many different methods for people who want this. But cultivation of Krishna consciousness is different. The particular word used by Srila Rupa Goswami in this connection is anusilana, or cultivation by following the predecessor teachers, acharyas. As soon as we say cultivation, we must refer to activity. Without activity, Krishna consciousness alone, without activity, consciousness alone cannot help us. All activities may be divided into two classes. One class may be for achieving a certain goal, another may be for avoiding some unfavorable circumstances. It's a very, very powerful statement. In this, the first reflection is purely around this, which fits into this context. Srila Prabhupada says that it is not simply inaction for people who like to be inactive or devote their time to silent meditation. So Prabhupada says, Krishna consciousness means activity. So, and how that activity can happen? That activity can happen by cultivation, and cultivation can happen when we follow in the footsteps of great acharyas, anusilana. And what it actually involves? It actually involves, number one, achieving a certain goal, and number two, it means to remove some unfavorable situations. So Sri Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami did exactly the same thing. They were wanting to achieve a specific goal of going and being with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and take part in his movement and become a relevant disciple. For that, they worked hard in getting rid of the unfavorable situation. So what does a relevant disciple mean? Just by becoming a disciple of so-and-so spiritual master, but not working in the direction as delineated by my spiritual master and the acharyas, and constantly just, you know, asking what can I do for you and not just trying to do any endeavor. Prabhupada very clearly says, if you are inactive, a silent meditation is not going to help us. A silent meditation is not going to help us, Prabhupada is very clearly saying, because Srila Prabhupada did not want us to become a scholar. Srila Prabhupada wants us to become devotees. Devotees means devotional service without any ulterior motive. Those who are engaged in this activity are devotees. For sure, there are different levels. For sure, it begins with some endeavor and just hearing. But since we are in discussing Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita, some deeper aspects of Krishna consciousness, let's go deeper with the presumption that the premises on which we are discussing is just not to clarify some basics of Krishna consciousness. We all have to agree that the basics of Krishna consciousness, of coming in contact with devotees, going to temple, they are all primarily pretty much need to be in place if you want to go deeper. And when for us to go deeper, what is being spoken about is trying to work to achieve a goal for serving your spiritual master, anusilana, and also work hard to remove an unfavorable situation. So the first reflection in today's discussion is to become a relevant disciple. Each and every one of us should try hard to become a relevant disciple to our spiritual master. Otherwise, we will be a burden in our system. Being burdened to the spiritual master is no way helping in spiritual master's mission. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj, in his final days before he left this planet, he very clearly made a statement. Because that time, the entire Gaudiya Math had got their own confusions and misunderstandings, that Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj got so much frustrated that he said that let me sell off all the buildings, furnitures, and convert them into money to print books and distribute them. So Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj had so many disciples. It was once in Radhakund, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj had spent personal time with Srila Prabhupada. That time Srila Prabhupada was a grihastha. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj had many other brahmachari and sannyas disciples that time. Srila Prabhupada spent quite a long time with Abhay Charanaranda Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada. Every disciple came and said to their Guru Maharaj, my dear Gurudev, you are spending time with your grihastha. Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj said, I am paraphrasing them, that he will preach the glories of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and is a very sincere student. So we need to make sure that we work in such a way, we serve in such a way
that we become a relevant disciples to our spiritual master. Not for showing off, not for getting recognition, not for getting identity, not to come closer in the physical proximity, but to make sure that we contribute in his mission, even in an insignificant manner, and not becoming a burden in the system. So our first reflection is that for us to become useful in this moment, we should learn to become a relevant disciple to Srila Gurudev and Srila Prabhupada. We need to make it happen as early as possible. Otherwise, in spite of being initiated in this movement, in spite of having a wonderful opportunity, we would become a burden. How there used to be caste Brahmanas, how there used to be very external practicing of scriptures, which ruined the Vedic civilization. The reason why Vedic civilization collapsed is because Brahmanas misused their opportunity to serve for their sense gratification. Brahmanas took authority in their hand and tried to exploit the society. Brahmanas started to set bad example, and that led to the downfall of Varnashrama system. And by the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and Rupa Goswami, once again we are trying to recreate that Varnashrama system as Daiva Varnashrama, which Srila Prabhupada wanted and all the Acharyas wanted. It is the duty of each and every one of us in this movement to not be a burden against that. And the way we become a burden is if we also become caste devotees. What is this caste devotees meaning? We look like a devotee. Our Kantimala, our Tilak, our Shika, we are bead bag. We look like devotees. But we are internally a hypocrite.
Mataji, we can't hear. Not able to hear Mataji.
Yes, yes, he has got cut off. We are waiting for him to reconnect.
Hare Krishna Mataji, 10-foot pranam, all Goshal of Rupath and Guru Dev. Notable to hear Mataji. Now, Prabhu is trying to reach him.
Hare Krishna?
Yes, Prabhu.
Yeah, sorry, I got, you know, thrown out of the call, so I'm sorry. Okay, so we were discussing about the spiritual master and how the disciple should try to be a relevant one, because it's the duty of every disciple to serve the spiritual master dutifully. So our first reflection had been to become a relevant disciple and not to become an external hypocrite. And I was just explaining that how this movement, we have a very responsible days ahead, that we have to torch, take forward Srila Prabhupada's legacy. So we need to make sure that somehow or other we become very committed to our spiritual master's vision and mission, and you know, serve him. So that's our first reflection. And Srila Prabhupada writes that just becoming a silent practitioner, just to become a silent meditation and having just consciousness developed will not help in order to get into activity. Our second reflection is that this Krishna consciousness is a very rare process. Because of our Krishna consciousness understanding or Krishna consciousness process, we are now in the train that takes us back home, back to Godhead. But then, if we don't take advantage of this process correctly, if we try to miss this train somehow, then the loss is ours. So the second reflection is, we are going to discuss about the greatness of this process which Mahaprabhu is offering us by analyzing the stages in which this process is made available to us. The first stage of this process is that we are already in a state where we accept the philosophy theoretically. It is extremely rare to come to an understanding that I am not this body, or come to an acceptance but all more interesting thing is that this understanding that we are not this body, spirit, soul, Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, we are servant of the Supreme Lord. If somebody in the movement, who are in the movement for quite a while, hear this statement, we tend to believe that this is some basic knowledge. When Srila Prabhupada was mentioning about cultivation, when Srila Prabhupada was mentioning about anusilana, when Srila Prabhupada was mentioning working towards the goal, when Srila Prabhupada was referring about giving away unwanted, unfavorable things, so there's a deeper essence, a deeper meaning inside that. So we are very happy today that we are all at a stage of acceptance of Krishna consciousness, which is very, very rare. Manushyanam sahasreshu kasyad yadisiddhaye yatatam api siddhanam kasyad mambeti tatvatah. We completely agree that it is extremely rare to be part of this Krishna consciousness movement. It's definitely very, very rare. It's not quite easy to be part of this. So this layer of first layer of acceptance is what we have gained, and I call that as a layer of rarity, because it is not so easy to come in contact with this Krishna consciousness process. It is not so easy to be engaged in this Krishna consciousness movement. It is not so easy to come to a theoretical understanding that we are not this body, spirit, soul, and Krishna is Supreme Personality of Godhead. That's the first layer or the first level. The second level is that, having accepted this, we theoretically know this, but do we live by that? No. Having accepted this, the second layer is the layer of discussion and learning. We tend to go surrender to a spiritual master, ask relevant questions from him. So the trying to get to that state. So all of us in this movement, we are very complacent that now we are initiated. We are very complacent that we are now part of this process and accepted. Theoretically, we know all the philosophies. But what is more difficult is that from the layer of theoretical acceptance, go for discussions and questions and submissions and service and learn from the spiritual master, from a bona fide source, from an authority, submitting ourselves and eagerly ready to discuss Krishna consciousness. So discussion and the stage of discussion and learning is a second stage, where from acceptance level we are going one level forward from acceptance to discussion. So we are trying to discuss more how to understand I am not this body, spirit, soul, how to understand Krishna Supreme Personality of Godhead, how to understand that my relationship with Krishna is to serve him eternally, how to understand this material world is a temporary place of suffering. So we are eager enough to go forward and discuss and learn. Discuss and eagerly learn, that's the second stage. So the stage of discussion and learning is very difficult, not so easy, because for that we need to submit our ego, for that we need to submit ourselves to the bona fide source, and in that process we transform, but it is not so easy. All those who have accepted to be part of this wonderful movement, all those who have accepted about the Siddhanta are not ready to learn and surrender and learn. Only those who have shown additional interest, only those who have shown inclination to progress in Krishna consciousness, they have shown interest in discussion and learning. So more than acceptance stage itself is rare. So more than acceptance is discussion and learning. And more than discussion and learning is a stage of understanding. All that you discuss, we may not be able to understand. So Krishna writes that if somebody, Prabhupada writes in many places in Bhagavad Gita, we should practice Krishna consciousness in such a way to understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Sri Krishna. 6th canto, 16th chapter, text number 54, Prabhupada writes in the purport. So Sri Prabhupada says, in our Krishna consciousness process, we should work hard to understand the transcendental activities of the Supreme Lord. By understanding the transcendental activities of the Supreme Lord, we will never come back to this material world. Janma karma chane devyam evam yovedi tatvataha tyaktva deham punar janma naiti mameti so Arjuna. So Prabhupada writes that whoever is trying to discuss and learn, even though it's difficult, and after that, if somebody comes to an understanding finally, in that stage of the understanding is very, very special. And the last stage is the stage of applying that understanding. So the reason I brought this four stages or four layers is that in our movement, in our process, There are many, many people who are there at the stage of acceptance. Great, glorious. If you go and tell your understanding, theoretical understanding to a normal person, they will think we are a scholar. They will think that we are a saint. They will think we are talking about something very, very great. So that's a stage of acceptance which is rare. But more glorious is what we have accepted, we wish to go and try to discuss and learn by asking relevant questions. So that stage is a stage of difficulty because it's not so easy. But more glorious is that when you discuss and learn, we try to understand the Siddhanta. So the Siddhanta is not something easily understandable by normal people, so you tend to understand them. And more glorious to that is the stage of application, and that stage is called stage of divinity. So acceptance is rare, discussion is difficult, understanding is special, and application is divine. So the reason I am trying to bring this point is that the entire Rupanugas, the entire Prabhupadanugas, the entire special contribution by this great Acharya is not just limiting ourselves to prepare on the Siddhanta part of it, but to help us apply the Siddhanta in our life. So Sri Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami, in their association with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, they made sure that they did not stop in the theory, that they applied also. So what Mahaprabhu is going to preach to Rupa Goswami now, what Mahaprabhu is going to preach to Sanatana Goswami in the future, both of them, you will see in their life how they applied. At every point in time, they were so single-pointedly focused on their agenda, they applied what they learned, what they were instructed by Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. So they went through these four layers. They went to the layer of acceptance, they went to the layer of discussion and learning, they went to the layer of understanding, and they also came to the layer of application. So every relevant disciple, or everybody who wants to become a relevant disciple to the spiritual master and just do not want to be a burden in the system, need to go through these four stages. So today we have to analyze, are we in the stage of acceptance only, or are we in the stage of discussion and learning, try to learn more and ask questions and go deeper, not from the perspective of becoming a scholar, but from the perspective of becoming a real student and a servant, and how much we have understood and how much we are ready to apply what we understood. It is very important. If the application is not there, Srila Prabhupada says, consciousness alone won't help us. We are not discounting about, you know, reading Bhagavatam, we are not discounting about anything, but we are very much concerned that if we just stay as a scholar and does not participate in the transcendental devotional service, which means performing activities without any ulterior motive. So the second reflection is that we need to make sure, we need to understand, we need to somehow or other apply in our life the Siddhanta that we learned, the Siddhanta that we are understanding, Siddhanta that we have accepted, and just not remain as a bookish person. So this is the second reflection that we learn from Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami. When Rupa Goswami was in Vrindavan, a Digvijay Pandit came. So this Digvijay Pandit, he came to meet some scholars in Vrindavan. When he came and met the scholars in Vrindavan, he already had got a, you know, certificate from everywhere that he's a Digvijay Pandit. He's won over everybody all over the world. So this guy came with a plan that if I get victory in Vrindavan, then I would be, you know, a person who doesn't have anybody else to win me from all the four directions. So when he came to Vrindavan, he asked everybody to come for a debate. So everybody said that we are not interested in debating with you. You please go and meet Sri Rupa Goswami. If Rupa Goswami is definitely, you know, giving his verdict that you are a scholar, then we'll all follow because we all respect Rupa Goswami, and that's good enough. So this Digvijay Pandit came to Rupa Goswami. He said, "My dear sir, I was told by your friends and associates and students that you are a great scholar and I wish to have a debate with you. So Sri Rupa Goswami said that what is the purpose of this debate? So he said that the purpose of this debate is to become a Digvijay Pandit. I want to be victorious in all the four directions. So is that the only purpose? He said, yes, that is the only purpose. So Rupa Goswami took the certificate from him, wrote in it saying that I, Rupa Goswami, declared that I got defeated by Digvijay Pandit and he won over. So without even having a single minute of time wasting or debating with this guy, he declared the other person, yes, you won over me. So this Digvijay Pandit got so surprised as well as was so happy that now he got certificate from everywhere that he is the great scholar. When he stepped out on the gate, Jiva Goswami was there. Jiva Goswami was Rupa Goswami's cook at that point in time. Jiva Goswami did not want to let this guy go off like that. So he stopped him. He said, so why don't you have a debate with me? So this Digvijay Pandit said that, no, I just now got a declaration from your master that he declared me as Digvijay. That's all right. Why don't you have a discussion with me? So Digvijay Pandit asked, who are you? That I am a cook to this guy. You're just a cook. What will you discuss with me? What do you know? That's all right. You just go ahead and ask whatever you want to ask. So then the Digvijay Pandit and Jiva Goswami had a very good discussion. And finally, Jiva Goswami won the debate. So Digvijay Pandit could not even comprehend what happened just then. So he had accepted the defeat. So Jiva Goswami said, please right now write and give me, I, Digvijay Pandit, declare that I got defeated by the cook of Srila Rupa Goswami and sign and give me. So this guy, gave this signature and said that he got defeated and he made him, leave. So Jiva Goswami came to Rupa Goswami and gave this letter, said that, Gurudev, I'm very happy to share that Digvijay Pandit has accepted his defeat. Rupa Goswami, when he saw that, he was very, very upset. He said that you have not understood our purpose. You have shown your pride and hence you are unfit to be my cook. Get out of this ashram. He was so furious. And he threw him out of the ashram. He could send out Jiva Goswami, who is one of the great scholars in this movement. Jiva Goswami was crying and weeping. And he went into a small bhajan kutir and stopped eating, stopped all the activities and just kept on crying and weeping. And finally, Sanatana Goswami had to intervene. And the story goes further. Sanatana Goswami intervened, went and spoke to Rupa Goswami, pacified. There were two instructive, important instructions here. Number one, that the reason Rupa Goswami was not interested in this debate is that the whole purpose of this Krishna consciousness movement is not to prove a point. Rupa Goswami is here to make sure that the Siddhanta is translated into lifestyle, and he wanted to show to the whole world what is Krishna consciousness way of living. Krishna consciousness is just not part of living or just some scholarly initiative. So this Digvijay Pandit just wanted to point. This is called Jati devotees, caste devotees. We try to become caste devotees, we try to become externally Krishna consciousness look alike, but internally hypocrite. which is what Rupa Goswami was against, which is what Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was against. Just two verses before, very nicely it was explained that how, just verse number 53 or 52, very nicely explained, if a person is in devotional life but does not do the devotional activity, even though he might be a great brahmana, what is the use? And on the other hand, if somebody is performing very nice devotional service, but even if he's a dog eater, what is the problem? So the whole point of Krishna consciousness process is such that we need to make sure, I'll read this, this is verse number 50. Lord Krishna said, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu saying this, even though a person is a very learned scholar of the Sanskrit Vedic literatures, he is not accepted as my devotee unless he is pure in devotional service. Even though a person is born in a family of dog eaters, he is very dear to me if he is pure devotee who has no motive to enjoy fruitive activities or mental speculation. Indeed, all respects should be given to him and whatever he offers should be accepted. Such devotees are as worshipable as I am. So my second point was to explain that it is imperative for us to understand the purpose of Krishna consciousness is not at the stage of acceptance, is not just at the stage of understanding, discussion and understanding, is not at the stage of understanding, it's at the stage of application, and when you apply Krishna consciousness in our life, that's where the whole circle comes in. Probably you may take time, but in the frame of our mind, we need to know that where do we stop? We don't stop at theory, we stop in action. So this is the second reflection. The third reflection is that for us to get to the stage of application, we need to have utmost amount of honesty, and with that honesty, we need to serve our spiritual master and try to yearn from within so that we make a progress to the stage of doing devotional service. Because doing devotional service is not by our choice. Doing devotional service means we should be empowered. So unless we are honest to ourselves, unless we are going deep within ourselves and try to get rid of all the hypocrisy and trying to become a relevant disciple, we will be a so-called external devotee and will not make any relevance to this movement. So the third reflection is that Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu gave himself to Rupa and Sanatana, he gave himself to Gopala Bhatta, he gave himself to Raghunath Das Goswami, he gave himself to all the closest associates because they showed the character of utmost honesty in serving Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu with their full heartfelt content. The third reflection is that for us to put ourselves into action, as we discussed a couple of weeks before, devotional service or the opportunity to serve the Supreme Lord, we need to be empowered. For the empowerment, we need to deserve. And the deservingness comes from how much we yearn from within. And that yearning comes from how much sincere we are in our chanting of Hare Krishna Mahamantra. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. So it is very important to know that our chanting of Hare Krishna Mahamantra, one of the first contributions or one of the earlier contributions of the chanting of Hare Krishna Mahamantra is that it helps us to identify, feel, experience that I am guilty. The more you chant, the more we feel the sense of guiltiness that I am not doing anything useful for our movement, something that I am doing for the spiritual master. So something is wrong within me. So let me try to seek help. So that's the third reflection. When we are progressing in Krishna consciousness, if we have never felt guilty of our not able to do services, and we are complacent in our Krishna consciousness state, that's not a very healthy stage. So see, Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami, you'll also see other Goswamis they showed some sense of urgency, and they also showed some sense of commitment in moving forward in their mission. So the point that I want to bring in is that for us to become a relevant disciple, for us to apply Krishna consciousness in doing, by doing action, not just stay at understanding and acceptance level, we need to get deeper in our heart and try to honestly introspect. And for that, I said as the stages, we need to yearn, and that yearning comes from our chanting, and by chanting we'll definitely develop the feeling of guilty, and that will force us to try to seek some help from a bona fide source by which we will be engaged in Krishna service. The qualification for us to participate in the service is not knowledge. The qualification for us to participate in service is our submission to the bona fide process and eager to listen that authority, and that is good enough for us to actively participate in the service. I have told the story before. A dean from Osmania University went and met Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj. So this dean went to discuss with Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj to discuss about some Siddhanta. When he met Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj, Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj sent him to the kitchen to help the pujari. And after finishing the pujari service, he came out and thanked Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Maharaj and said that my heart is now lighter and I am able to experience a joy, and whatever questions I had, I'm getting some clarity, and he became ready to understand the Siddhanta. So what happens is that when we are participating in the service under the order of the spiritual master, we become a qualified servant, and that helps us to become a relevant disciple to the spiritual master. I'm sorry we had a lot of disturbances today. I started off late and in between the call got cut. So I'm not sure if I lost the thread in my presentation. I'll just summarize the three reflections that I brought in, as a part of churning these five verses. The reflection number one is that each and every one of us should try to be very careful, very conscious, very cautious, and very sincere in becoming a relevant disciple. The difference between a disciple and a relevant disciple is a relevant disciple is the one who tries to empathize, follow exactly in the footsteps of the spiritual master, and work in fulfilling his mission. And we discussed that how Srila Prabhupada tells in Nectar of Devotion introduction that just consciousness alone won't help us. We need to get into activity, which means every relevant disciple should have a goal to accomplish and should have plans to give up the unfavorable activities which are against the goal. So our duty to make sure that somehow or other we try to constantly think about how to become more and more relevant in this movement rather than burden in this movement. We should never ever be a burden to this process, and this burden in the system is a very, very unfortunate thing. So reflection number two that we discussed was that for us to become relevant, we need to understand how the Krishna consciousness process works. The Krishna consciousness process works in four layers. Layer of acceptance, layer of discussion and learning, layer of understanding, and layer of application. Layer of acceptance itself is very, very rare. Layer of discussion and learning is not only rare but also difficult. Layer of understanding is not only rare but also difficult. It is also very, very special because not everybody gets to an understanding stage. But the layer of application is not only rare, not only difficult, not only special, but it is also divine. Hence, we need to make sure that we don't stay in just a acceptance level, but we go to the application level. We saw how Rupa Goswami moved on from an acceptance all the way to application, and that's how this movement is flourishing. So thanks to all of them. And last reflection is that for us to become a relevant disciple and to get to the stage of application, we need to have utmost level of honesty, and hence we should safeguard ourselves from being a caste devotee. A caste devotee is the one who look alike a devotee but does not have a consciousness of a devotee. The whole Vedic system collapsed, the whole civilization collapsed, the whole Varnashrama collapsed because Brahmanas misused their position and so many other great people, they misused their authority, and hence we being devotees, having Hare Krishna Mahamantra, having part of this wonderful Sankirtan movement, should not misuse our rights, should not become a hypocrite from within, which means then we will become a part of a caste devotee, and that will be a precedence for downfall of our own life, and it's a very, very unfortunate situation. And to avoid that, we need to have an utmost level of honesty within ourselves, and to have an utmost level of honesty, we need to definitely chant Hare Krishna Mahamantra. This Hare Krishna Mahamantra chanted in a very prayerful mood helps us. The first or one of the earlier experiences for every sincere practitioner is it will help us, make us feel, make us experience a sense of guilty that I am still not yet made necessary progress. And with that guilt, we will be yearning to come out of that guilt, and for that we will seek help. And in the process of seeking help, we will definitely be empowered to do devotional service. So the honesty is just not a dry honesty. This honesty will lead us that we will be empowered to do devotional service, because devotional service cannot be taken, devotional service has to be given. So a spiritual master or a spiritual authority should entrust us, should empower us to serve in the Sankirtana movement. So with these three reflections, I would like to end. And once again, sorry for the snag in between. We are at the mercy of technology. So just in case if I did not, you know, join the dots somewhere, please excuse me, and let me know if there are any questions or comments. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki jai. Shri Shri Chaitanya Charitamrita ki jai. Any questions or comments?
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, thank you very much for the summary at the end. I got cut off in between. I have one question, and my question, I think you answered it in the end, about these levels of these layers, as you said, from acceptance to questioning to understanding and then to application. They're very fluid. Sometimes I feel it's not so cut and dried. So you said at the end, to actually get to that point of progressing, we have to analyze where we are honestly, and then feel guilty, and then once we feel guilty, we'll have a desire to progress, and then by chanting more earnestly, yearningly, we will become empowered. Is that the understanding?
That understanding is perfect. I just want to have one point added to say that the reason I made this point is it's not a logical single step that we finish full acceptance at one level, then we go. This is not just a sequential step. It's actually fluid. But the if you have this understanding that I cannot just limit myself only to theory, I need to get into application. That need to go in each and every one of our heart, because somehow or other, because of the education system, because of some bad examples, because of some luxury of lifestyle, we do not want to get into application, because application means getting into the level of menial service and getting into the service attitude, which means humble and try to shun our ego. So in our core of our heart, the movement is not just a scholarly movement. The movement is a serving movement, developing the mood of the service. So the process that you clarified is what I just, said, and that's correct. I just said this point to make sure, to reiterate, we just don't become lax in getting into application. Application is a very important stage. And I, for corroborating that, I gave the passage from Nectar of Devotion introduction, which Prabhupada emphasizes.
Okay, thank you, Prabhu. So we truly have to, it's very much of a self-analysis. You have to be basically brutally honest with yourself. And if you want to really advance, you really need to do the necessary things. Not, as you said, we're so attached to these luxuries.
I will tell you an interesting secret.
Yes, please, go ahead, Prue.
Yeah, I'll just tell you an interesting secret. Sometimes you will not even be able to understand the Siddhanta unless you apply it. The point is, many times we will be thinking we are humble. But if somebody humiliates you, that's when your humility is tested. Unless you are perturbed, you do not know how tolerant are you. Unless you are bothered, you do not know how patient are you. So, when you are actually getting into devotional service, what happens is that it is like a person who is studying medicine, he is getting into practice. Definitely the theory that he studied in the college is going to help him. But when he is putting in the practice, that's when he will actually realize what it means to put what he learned in practice. And a lot more things that he has never understood during theory session, he will understand when he is in practice. So the full understanding, the full acceptance, the full clarity will come in only when we apply. When we do devotional service, so many things that we theoretically did, we will get to know, we will get to clarify. And this is my personal experience that, you know, Prabhupada writes in the preface of Nectar of Instruction. The advancement in Krishna consciousness is possible when the attitude of the practitioner is changed. And to that person, knowledge is revealed. I'm paraphrasing it, I'm not using the exact words. So the point is that knowledge is revealed from within. So knowledge from within is revealed. How it is revealed? When the clogging is removed, when the covering is removed. And how the covering is removed? When we do the service. How you do the service? When you have the understanding. How you have the understanding? When you have a questioning. How you have the questioning? So this is like a very good, you know, layering. So this is just to dissect the Siddhanta and understand for our practical application. Otherwise, we just read all these literatures on the very top layer without knowing the purpose of all the Siddhanta and discussions are directing us to make sure that we put our hands dirty and do service.
Thank you, Prabhu. Thank you.
Hare Krishna. Many of
them? Yes, yes.
Thank you. Any other questions or comments?
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji, Dandavat Pranam, all Krishna, Prabhupada, and Gurudev, Jai Jai Shri Radhe Shyam. How wonderfully you explain all the layers and the Rupa Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu story. Like we feel we entered in the Leela, that much potency in your lecture. Thank you very much, Dandavat, all Krishna, Prabhupada, and Gurudev.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Prabhuji. Thank you for a wonderful class. Prabhuji, so this is what you described as kind of like Sambandh, Abhideya, and Prayojana, isn't it? In a way?
Yeah, in a way it is like that. It's Sambandh, Abhideya, Prayojana. I was just trying to correlate them, split them from a very practical viewpoint because many times the Sambandha Jnana, if it is not rightly understood. So if you see Sambandha, Abhideya and Prayojana, in each of them these four layers are there. Even in Sambandha, there is a question of acceptance, discussion, understanding and application. How do you apply your Sambandha? I will apply it just by picking up my bead bag and start chanting Hare Krishna Mahamantra. That itself is an application. So how will you apply these four steps in Abhideya? How do you apply these four steps in Prayojana? So everywhere these four things are again and again coming, because at no point in time we should be just a bunch of theoretical analyzing person or a scholar or a jnani. Because in Rupa, in Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, third wave, Rupa Goswami writes one of the first paragraphs. He says, knowledge is the biggest obstacle for us to do pure devotion service. It's a very powerful statement. What does it actually mean? means that we need to use knowledge, go to a stage of love, because the reason why we are gaining all this knowledge is not to be a scholar. The reason all we are gaining this knowledge is eventually to be in love. And the biggest obstacle in love is knowledge. That is why in Vrindavan, nobody wants your Bhagavatam class. If you go and tell, I am not this body spiritual, they say, get out. In Vrindavan, all the gopis wanted to love Krishna. So there he is not master, there he is friend, there he is lover, there he is son, there he is, you know, servant. So the point I am trying to say, Sambandha Abhideya Prayojana is definitely part of Vaidhi Sadhana Bhakti. And eventually you move forward, you move forward, you move forward. That's why I said in the middle of the class, the basic premises of this discussion is to understand that the basics of Krishna consciousness are already understood, so we are churning much more deeper into it. So at every stage you will see this four layering. Even in Prayojana there is this four layering. To accept Prayojana, to understand Prayojana, and to apply how in Prayojana will function. Am I making sense?
Yes, yes, Babaji. Thank you so much. Thank you very much for that.
Thank you.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna Prabhuji, Dhanavad Pranam. Thank you so much, Prabhuji. Very, very nectarian class. Nectarian because we can see that, you know, you are giving us the gems of your realizations of years of practice of the philosophy. So, I mean, it's like a ripened fruit of your experience and that's why it is a gem.
Oh my God.
Thank you so much, Prabhuji. These things, you know, we can't get it on our own, and in spite of so many years of practice, because you're so sincere and you're getting to know the glimpse of what we should be achieving and what we should be thinking in the mind while doing devotional service to please Guru and Krishna. So thank you so much.
Okay. I'll give a small story. Indradyumna Maharaj took a group of disciples to Barsana few years before. When he took the disciples to Varsana, they took from Vrindavan or maybe Varsana area, and that sadhu went with them and explained so many wonderful pastimes, and all the disciples, all the devotees who travel with Maharaj, they're so happy, so happy. Then when they finished the yatra, they were so so much thankful to that Babaji and said that, how come you know so many stories and so many pastimes which you have never heard? So that Babaji put his hand in his bag, he had a shoulder bag, and pulled out Krishna book. He said that, I've read this book 22 times. All that I said is there in this book only. So all I can say is that so there is nothing that special that is coming out apart from what is written in Srila Prabhupada's book. So the more you churn, the more you get the nectar. The more you misunderstand, you'll get poisoned. So better churn it nicely in the side of devotees. Is that okay?
Jai Ho Srila Prabhupada ki.
Thank you so much, Prabhupada.
Thank
you so much, Prabhu. Thank you for the wonderful churning and all the nectar. Thank you so much. Very nice class, very beautiful discussion and nice question answers. Thank you all so much for actively participating. Anyone else has any questions before we go ahead?
I think we should stop because I really went over about 20 minutes and in between all
no.
Thank you so much, everybody. Hare Krishna. Srila Prabhupada ki jai.
Hare Krishna. Thank you very much.
Hare Krishna, before we end the call, I just have one announcement to make. Do we have Lalitangi Mataji on the call still?
Yeah, yes, Mataji.
Mataji, you can go ahead, Mataji, with the announcement.
Her Grace Jai Gopi Mataji, left her body today morning, 8:42 a.m. I also got the news from the Everyday Chant Call WhatsApp group, and it's my great fortune to be able to glorify her a little bit. I know her a little bit for little years, but like as Prabhuji told in the lecture, so many points, she is like a person who has applied these things. Some people are preachers by practice and by preaching as well, and some people just practice and by their example they are preaching. So Mataji was one such rare gem. We got the opportunity to be with her during Sadhu Sangha, driving her up and down, and always I have seen her always chanting in the chanting with a bead bag throughout the journey and whenever I saw her. And I think she moved here early 1980s or so, and around that early 80s, I'm not sure if it is 1980, she got initiated with Bir Krishna Maharaj. And that time, they were the only devotee family in the Charlotte, and as we know, that devotees used to travel in vans. So Shraddhanjali Mataji, her daughter, was telling me that every week they would get devotees, brahmacharis, coming to their house and staying and taking prasadam and going around in this area. There was no temple. The first temple in North Carolina was 1985. That was Bir Krishna Maharaj, built by his own hands in Hillsboro. So Mataji had served a lot of devotees like that, and I'm not sure about how many kids she has, but at least I know like four of them are initiated. Our head pujari in the Hillsboro temple and our regular Mataji, who is a regular caller in the Everyday Chant Call, Krishna Priya Mataji, is her daughter. And her Krishna Priya Mataji and her Prabhu are the head pujaris in the Hillsboro temple. And Shraddhanjali Mataji and Dwaipayana Prabhu are in Orlando temple serving. And their children and grandchildren, it's a huge tree of devotees. So this Mataji didn't speak much English, but she would always be on the japa call, and she would be the first to announce her name in the morning conference at 7:20. Some time back, she was really sick, and we were praying for her, and she was getting better, and she was giving her association. But as we know, this world, nobody, nothing is permanent, and Krishna has chosen to take her. But it's a heavy heart to miss such a nice devotee like her. And so I request that we can all pray for her blessings. And she has lived a life. She lost her husband early when she came here, I think. And then she had grown her daughters and sons on her own with hard work. And she never left chanting. And she was a source of inspiration for the whole family to become devotees. So it's my great fortune and blessing to be able to share a little bit what I know about this great personality. I pray to her and to all the Vaishnavas so that we can follow in her footsteps and remind devotees. Thank you, Preeti Vilasini Mataji, for this opportunity.
Thank you so much, Lalitangi Mataji. We will all pray for her. She was a great asset to this call also. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for glorifying her and telling so much about her. Thank you, Mataji. We can end the call now. Vancha Kalpataru Vescha, Krupa Sindhu Bhayavacha, Patitanam Pavanebhyo, Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha. Ananta Koti Vaishnavranda Kijai, Srila Prabhupada Kijai, Sri Sri Chaitanya Charitamrita Kijai, His Grace Ram Giridhari Prabhu Kijai. Ananta Koti Vaishnavranda Kijai. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Hare Krishna.